Hello there. I wanted to speak to you guys as an aspect of all that is, an aspect of consciousness, and give you guys a little bit of feedback on my experience and how things have played out for me over the course of last year and also going back into 2013. I believe it was June 13th, 2013, where I met somebody from my grandfather's stepwife's side of the family, her daughter. She was a psychic and a mystic from Canada who came and visited us in Southern California on that day in 2013. And at that point, I had been doing a lot of sun gazing, so I had been allowing light particles or information integrate into my manifestation by way of sun gazing. Of course, within an hour of sunrise and within an hour of sunset, those are the times that it is feasible to do that. And I also focused my consciousness to the back or the pineal gland or the third eye within my mind, so I would push my consciousness back there so that the light would enrich my third eye or the pineal gland, or I guess now I would say from the research that I've gathered is the connection to the higher self or the connection to the innate consciousness. And in 2013 I met this seer named Shadowday and actually had a sun gazing experience with her. But before I went and sun gazed with her, we ate Persian food at this market in Irvine. And after 5 minutes of meeting me, sitting with my grandfather and my mother and my grandfather's wife, Soraya, she said, "I've never met anyone like you in my life. You're not human. Your soul is elsewhere with the guardian and Archangel Michael. And your 12th and 13th chakra are open. Now within many systems, there is belief, especially within the Pleiadians, that there are 12 chakras, and I believe that there is 12 chakras, but for us to come into unity with the cosmos fully, the 13th chakra, or my chakra, must be integrated. And last year, after actually channeling in 2014, you know, having Source come through me, I wrote about everyone being, you know, a fragment of the divine, an aspect of the prime creator, the Father, Mother, God. And this consciousness is something that after I actually channeled that and wrote that, I later listened to a Barbara Marciniak channeling or information about the Pleiadians, and I have had the ability to discern not by way of societal or religious or any dogma or anything other than what on a vibrational level resonates with me, and I call that soul vibratory resonance. And I listened to Barbara Marciniak's post about this this consciousness that they were coming to bring us into higher consciousness, you know. And I started singing, you know, about the Pleiades when I heard it, and it just vibrated with me on such a high vibratory level. And you know, most of my life, it's like everything that I see and I believe as truth, I co-create with the universe. And she began to speak of the entity called the Prime Creator, and talking about how it began, you know, actually through an implosion of its own energy, endowed all things with consciousness, and that was through love, of course. And this resonated with me in a big way, and later in the video, she said that some beings speak of merging with God, you know, like coming, becoming one with God. And very interestingly, that happened to me last year. And she said that these beings may have merged with a portion of Prime Creator's energy, but the total information or data that would be transferred to the physical body through a full merging with the Prime Creator would actually destroy the physical vessel. And it actually says that the portion of the Prime Creator that whatever entity at the time merges with it, it's because it best suits its vibration at that time. And when I merged with that portion, that light and that love last year, it was like I was merging with this consciousness that after my accident in 2013, every job that I did was an avenue or an outlet for me to actually share about this consciousness, about this Christ consciousness. And it's very interesting, you know, the way that Shatterday the Seer spoke to me and spoke of my 12th and 13th chakra being open. I think that's interesting because this book I read called The Master Game, I read part of it, and it speaks of a sect of Christianity called the Cathar that believed lived in 12th and 13th century Occitania, or modern day France and Italy. Now they believed both in reincarnation, and they believed in 12 and 13 again. You know, it's like those numbers which add up to 7 if you add 1 plus 2, 1 plus 3. And in the Pleiades, there's 7 stars in the Pleiades, so it's all, everything's like kind of like mathematically correlated. But and like I said, you know, when I listen to things, I kind of co-create with them, you know, on an intuitive level, on a heart level, if it's true, and I think it's beneficial for the collective consciousness, you know, before this awakening and falling into more egoic aspects of myself, and, you know, anyways, but the 13th chakra, I think that was made or brought into my awareness in 2013. I think that has to do with the central sun in this galaxy, which is, you know, the creative creator energy that we all have within us. And, you know, last year, or actually this year, after I kind of fell back into, you know, ego, I was operating quantumly, still, you know, while in ego, kind of going through the valley of the shadow of death, just, you know, feeling like an empty vessel, you know, but, you know, at the same time, on a quantum level, picturing, you know, every being that comes into contact with me, picturing all of their chakras activating, picturing, you know, enlightenment coming into their awareness, and also, you know, kind of like as a vessel, I was utilized. I don't know even if it was me that was doing it, but I would focus my consciousness into my heart chakra, and then I would project an aspect of my consciousness into our sun, and then further, I would project an aspect of my consciousness or into the 13th chakra in the central sun. And then as that aspect of my awareness entered into the central sun, I would feel this vibration of recognition or intuitive knowing go through my body. And then I would draw the energy from the central sun through our sun back here to Earth. And I think that this summer, this June 20th, this you know, the I read this this text, which I'll share with you. solstice, let's shake up the field together. An invitation to use the solstice to break up resistance to humanity's awakening, by Paris Diza. With the summer solstice in mind, I asked my longtime advisor, the I Ching, what could be done to dissolve resistance in the field and accelerate the awakening of humanity. Its answer was clear. Shake things up now and rouse them to new activity. Release new energy from the cloud of confusion. Why is the solstice important? The four most powerful points of the yearly cycle are the solstices and equinoxes, each one a three-day still point of pure and purifying spiritual energy. The universe uses these zero-point pauses to gather itself and bring everything into greater harmony. Huge amounts of negative images, energy, and general rubbish in the field are neutralized, and vast amounts of the unconditioned energy of loving light pour in to make new things possible. These still points are like eclipses in their magical power. This year, the summer solstice falls on the 20th. A solstice or equinox can occur anywhere from the 18th to the 23rd. Its entire window is the day before, the day of, and the day after, making the whole experience June 19th, 20th, and 21st. What can we do? We have made tremendous progress towards our awakening point over the last few decades, and especially the last few years. If we strike a strong, resonant chord together with the solstice wave, we can dissolve a great deal more of the inertia of the sleeping masses and the actively dark forces that have been trying to hold back this great change. If you want a global currency reset, this moment, well used, could significantly diminish the remaining resistance to it. Maintaining our focus continuously over the three-day window, using a combination of meditation, ceremony, and parties works best, and also being aware of how the energies are lining up for it days in advance and following through for days after. Holding a continuous focus from now through the weekend after will generate a wave of spiritual momentum that creates permanent results. We are now at the midpoint of the heart fire season of Yang energy, the time of the sun fully opens its heart to the planet. It is the full moon moment of the solar cycle, and it may seem harder to sit still to meditate, but meditation proves to be the most powerful thing we can do, as sitting still inside the still point allows us to align with what it is doing on Earth and in our personal lives. So plan some good still time focused on emptiness, surrender, and release, along with movement, ceremony, and sound making, and know that we are catching this wave together simultaneously. What are we doing this for? We are doing this to be free. We cannot battle dark forces into submission. Conflict perpetuates duality. Our aim should be to remember the truth of what we are, and thereby release ourselves from the grasp of anything or anyone dark. This vibrational shift will allow a harmony of heaven and earth. We are part of a spiritual coup de grace, a stroke of mercy that comes from a vibrational shift when the incoming energies are shaking up the galaxy so we can re-enter into unity consciousness. We are in a terrible and wonderful time of chaos and awe as we approach our zero point and begin to use our natural mind again. As Terence McKenna said in a discussion with Rupert Sheldrake and Ralph Abraham in 1992 at Esalen, love is what lies ahead at the end of the historical descent into novelty. It has to be. Now the reason there is a lot of freaking out is because the trip gets rougher as you approach the zero point. The ride is going to shake your teeth out in the last moments, and then you will touch the echelon, the divinely ordained end of history, and break through. And there we are. Happy solstice. So yeah, I kind of feel like the universe or God or source, you know, the creative source that I am, also a vessel of uses me and my connection to the central sun or the 13th chakra to, you know, I'm not saying necessarily that the reverberation of this light would not have come to pass if I was not aware of the fact that I was being utilized for its purpose, but through the combination of that projecting of my awareness into our sun, and then projecting further into the central sun, and then bringing light through the heart chakra to the earth plane for all of sentient beings to receive, I believe, you know, it is divinely ordained, and that the time of the Great Awakening, or the Great Second Wave, because it seems that last year there was a type of wave that we caught, but it was more based, I guess, out of my personal realization, or my personal merging with a portion of the Prime Creator's energy that created a focusing in on my personal awareness or my personal consciousness. Now, where this second wave and the work that I have done alchemically and metaphysically to transmute the collective, I believe, is going to be the merging and the removal of separation within every heart and every mind in existence, and the full remembrance of our true divine nature for all beings that are of light and love. And I believe that this capacity is you know, within our grasp and is at hand. So, God bless you. May you continue on this journey with every bit of knowing that you are all that is. You are that I am, and we will together overcome the sleep that the consciousness has on many on this current earth plane. But the earth plane is going to shift, and the thing about it is that those things within the masses' minds that are currently keeping them confined in duality will dissolve in the light of the consciousness that is inherent within them, that is waiting to be birthed or brought to the surface from within. So that's what I think is at hand. You know, I feel like we're on the precipice now. June 20th, you know, when I originally read that solstice post, I think it was that one, or it was another one that was maybe more tuned to the sun. That same, you know, people call it the Holy Spirit. You know, they have many names for this intuitive, spiritual connection. I called it soul vibratory resonance, but you know, when I read it, the creative source through me allowed me to see the soul vibratory resonance, or the connection of the central sun's emanations being brought to fruition within the heart and the mind of all that is. So may you have a blessed rest of the week. Is it Saturday? It's Saturday. Okay. Well, I hope you have a good weekend and enjoy, you know, your life. You know, and don't get stuck in the in the mind. Stay in the heart. I'll try to do the same. Thanks.